Okay, so I hope medyo nadalian kayo sa exam, second exam. Madali na lang talaga. And today we're going to finish chapter 8, which is the main memory. And main memory is an important resource that an operating system must manage. And I think we've finished some parts of this chapter. So, baka nakalimutan niyo lang. Okay. So, hardware support usually have base and limit registers to determine where to place the processes. And I think the last part was in the mobile, swapping in the mobile systems. This was the last topic that we discussed. The idea here is swapping is usually not typically supported in mobile systems because of the limitations in the memory structure used in mobile systems, and because mobile systems use flash memory, okay, for storage. So you have a limited amount, so swapping is not usually implemented in these systems. Okay. So we now move on to allocation of memory. Okay. So memory, a program, said in the von Neumann stored program architecture, the program from the disk must be placed in memory, and in doing so, the operating system must allocate portions of memory. And physically, the memory is implemented as a contiguous bytes, you say an array of bytes, and the operating system will be responsible for allocating these bytes, right? And the earliest way to allocate main memory is contiguous allocation. What do we mean by contiguous allocation? A program has certain memory requirements. In contiguous allocation, what it means is that all memory that will be used by a process or the operating system should be in a contiguous memory location. So let's say 0 to 1,000, nandyan lahat ng process. 1,001 to 3,000, lahat ng memory na kailangan ng process sa contiguous allocation, magkakasunod. Okay, that's what I mean by contiguous allocation. And this was done because of limited memory. Okay? So the system, the main memory is merong part para sa operating system, merong part para sa user processes. Okay? And of course, we don't want processes to be accessing memory used by other processes. So as a form of protection, we have relocation registers. Okay? And you have the base register and you have a limit register that basically protects data or one process from accessing other processes' memory space. Okay? So this is the hardware support for relocation and limit register. So you have a program, move AX and then some variable. So that variable has a logical address. So using contiguous allocation, so you have a base, that logical address will be compared to a limit register. Okay? If less than, then a relocation list is added and you get to the physical memory. Okay? So one way to allocate is what they call multiple partition allocation. Right? So the idea here is the memory is divided into blocks, okay? And the blocks can be fixed size or variable size. Okay? So what happens here is the degree of multiprogramming is determined by the number of partitions. The more partitions you have, the more processes you can place in the memory at one time, then the higher the degree of multiprogramming. Okay? So when a process exits, that the memory used by that process is allocated or returned to the operating system for later use by other processes. So as shown here, you have process 8. Initially, you have the operating system here, and you have three processes. So there are at this point in time you have three processes. Then process A terminates. Then you have a hole here. Okay, it's a block of memory, available memory. Then another process comes in. It requires this amount of memory, so it is placed here. And then another process comes here, and then it's placed here. So basically, this is multiple partition allocation. Okay. So this is called the free partitions, and you have here the allocated partitions. Now, the allocation is basically called the dynamic storage allocation problem. If you think of this as algorithmically, then it can be stated as a dynamic storage allocation problem. And there are heuristics. It's an NP-complete problem. It's a difficult problem to solve. And usually they have heuristics to solve this. And this is called, these are the three common heuristics on how to perform this dynamic allocation, dynamic storage allocation. So the first one is first fit. So you find a hole in the memory that, so it, here comes a new process. Sasabihin ni process, oh, ito yung memory requirement na kailangan ko. Contiguous allocation to, ha? We are considering here contiguous allocation, meaning lahat ng memory na gagamitin ng process ay nakalagay, ay magkakasunod, isang block. Okay? Hindi pwedeng hiwa-hiwalay. Ha? Yun yung ibig sabihin ng contiguous allocation. Okay? So, the approach here in first fit, you find a hole that kung saan kasya yung, ano, yung process memory requirement ng process na yun. And yun yung unang ma-hit mo doon, doon mo siya ilalagay, yung process. Lahat, right? Yun yung gagamitin niya. The other one is best fit. Right? So, kung halimbawa, linear yung pag-search mo, so maghahanap, usually may list yung mga available blocks. Okay? You have the base and the limit register that defines the block. Okay? So, yung best fit, ang ginagawa niya, scan niya yung pinakamaliit na pwedeng magkasya yung requirement ng process, doon mo siya ilalagay. And then yung worst fit naman, ito yung pinakamalaki na pwede siyang magkasya, doon mo na ilagay yung process. Okay? So, the operating system must maintain two data structures. Okay? The first data structure is basically a list kung ano yung mga allocated na blocks, and another list kung ano yung mga free holds. Okay? Para alam niya kung saan yung mga available slots, available holds. Okay? Now, the problem with contiguous allocation, again, contiguous allocation, magkakasama lahat, magkakasunod na memory area, memory locations yung ano, yung paglalagyan ng process. Hindi pwedeng paghiwa-hiwalayin yung requirement, yung ano, yung memory na gagamitin niya. So, that suffers with external fragmentation, okay? So, fragmentation would mean na may mga butal ng memory na pag pinagsama-sama mo, pwede siyang maka-accommodate actually ng isa pang process, pero since hiwa-hiwalay sila, hindi mo pwedeng gawin yon. Okay? Now, internal fragmentation naman, kung halimbawa, worst fit yung ginamit mo, kumuha ka ng pinakamalaki, tapos konti lang pala yung gagamitin mo dun, yung internal fragmentation, yung natira dun sa malaking inallocate mo, minus nung size, yung actual size ng process. So, yun yung tinatawag na internal fragmentation. And that's actually a waste of memory. Okay? So, you need to solve that problem, and one way to solve that problem is via what we call compaction. So, sisiksikin mo. Okay? So, may mga butal-butal dyan, you need to, the operating system must have a process that will regain or gagawin niyang contiguous yung mga ano, contiguous yung mga hiwa-hiwalay na holes ng memory holes. Okay? So, doing that will actually incur additional overhead kasi additional task yun eh. So halimbawa every 1 hour kailangan mag-perform ng compaction yung kernel, and moving around processes in the memory will take some time. Okay, so that will be a problem, and especially kung meron kung kumbaga pag nag-implement ka ng tinatawag na swapping. So at this point, nag-perform ka ng compaction. Tapos meron kang naka-store doon sa ano, sa backing store mo. Pag niload mo siya, since nag-compaction ka, pwedeng ibang memory location na yung paglalagyan mo kasi nag-compaction ka na nga eh. So nung in-store mo siya doon sa disk, okay? iba yung location niya. Pero nung i-read mo na uli siya, iba na yung location niya. Kasi nag-compaction ka na eh. Right? So that is a problem. So, a solution, so una yung contiguous allocation. A solution sa architectural solution is to provide the next approach called segmentation. Okay? So segmentation, the idea is to separate the way programmers or developers view the main memory. Okay? So instead of a process, parang pag sinabi mo kasi na process, isang buong ganito siya, isang buong ganito siya. Contiguous, lahat yan, process 8. Pwede mo actually i-view yung process as separate logical segments. Okay? And logical segments would be like main program, procedure, function, method, object, stack, okay? Simple table arrays. Okay? So that's how a programmer views a program. So the architectural solution sa processor, okay, they tried to adapt this view of programmers in the hardware. Okay? So what happens is the logical address, so remember again, the logical address is the address as seen by the CPU, as seen by the programmer. So it will be broken down into different pieces. Okay? So you have the subroutine stack. So this basically will be the view of a program. Okay? So what happens in segmentation? So again, yung segmentation is hardware supported, no? Hardware supported. So this is the user space. Okay? So you have here the different, so these are the mappings, the different views of the components of a program. And what will happen is, this is the logical address space. Ang pwede mong gawin is, unlike sa contiguous memory, contiguous allocation, pwede mo actually paghiwa-hiwalayin yung mga parts ng program, ilagay mo sa iba't ibang parts ng memory. You get the idea? Kasi yung contiguous, magkakasama silang lahat sa physical memory. Sa segmentation, hiwa-hiwalay. Pwedeng hiwa-hiwalay. Itong part na to, halimbawa, subroutine siya, ilagay mo siya sa area na to. Itong part na to, ilagay mo siya sa area na to. But, the way the programmer, the way the developer sees these addresses is parang isang address space lang siya. Pero, dun sa actual memory, hiwa-hiwalay siya. You get the idea of segmentation and contiguous allocation. So, paanong ina-accomplish ngayon to ng processor? So, again, the processor will support this view in the architecture. And the logical address will consist of a tuple. Two tuple, you have the segment number and an offset. Okay? Unlike in the contiguous allocation, meron kang base register. Yung base register mo, nagpo-point dito. Okay? Tapos yung limit register mo, nagpo-point dito. So every memory access will be checked against that base and limit register. Kailangan contain siya doon. This is contiguous allocation. Whereas in segmentation, so actually, ang ano dito sa contiguous allocation, you have the actual logical address. Essentially, yung logical address is equal to the physical address, direct mapping. Okay? Pero dito sa segmentation, yung logical address mo is no longer an actual physical address. Okay? Merong konting abstraction na ginagawa. And the logical address will be composed of two parts. You'll have the segment number and an offset. Okay? So ito yung input mo ngayon. And in addition to this, kumbaga, okay, yung memory management, yung CPU, pag nag-a-address siya, segment number lagi, tapos yung offset. So kailangan may support yan for register. So you have a segment table. Yung segment table is a two-dimensional physical address. And each table entry has a base which contains the starting physical address where the segment resides in memory and a limit which specifies the length of the segment. So in a way similar din siya sa ano sa dun sa base and limit register dun sa contiguous allocation. However, dun kasi sa contiguous allocation, isa lang per process. Okay? Sa segmentation, merong base and limit for each section of the program. So meron tayong code seg. An example of this will be the code segment register. You have the data segment register, okay? The stack segment register, which represent the different components of the program. Okay? So kumbaga, apat at least in the case of the x86, right? And this information, this segment table, is stored in a segment table base register, which points to the segment table's memory location and memory, and a segment table length register, which indicates the number of segments used by a program. Okay? So again, this is dependent on the architecture. In the case of x86, which you learned in COMSci131, meron tayong code segment, data segment, stack segment, extra segment, F segment. Okay? So yun yung mga base registers na tinatawag for each particular segment. So you can define 4 segments. Okay? And yon. So how is protection achieved in the segmentation, right? So protection is achieved with each entry in the segment table, you associate a validation bit. Pag zero, illegal segment, hindi siya ginagamit. And you also have, you can actually set the privileges for the segment, right? And you have protection bits associated with segments like code sharing, okay? So also, since segments vary in length, memory allocation is a dynamic storage allocation problem. And okay, so example ng segmentation hardware. Okay. So segmentation hardware works like this. You have the CPU, sabi natin, yung address natin, yung logical address, unlike kanina sa contiguous allocation na isang value lang, which allocation in the memory, okay? Na chine-check against the base and the limit registers. Dito sa segmentation, yung logical address na ibibigay ng CPU sa memory management unit will be basically an offset to the segment table, okay? Ito yung tinatawag na, this is the offset, okay? The segment number on the segment table. This is a data structure. Ito yung sinasabi dito na segment table maps two-dimensional physical address, the base and limit. Okay, so you have the base and limit here. So, logical address will be look up siya dito, and then kukunin yung base value, and then i-check ngayon yung offset, the segment offset, if it is within the limit specified in the segment table. Pag no, then nag-a-access ka ng memory na outside dun sa para sa'yo. Dun sa na-set up mo na sa segment table. So you have a trap addressing error. Kung within naman, then you get the base address and then the offset and then that is the actual location in the physical memory. Now, you get the idea? So the main difference between contiguous and segmentation, ito kanina, isang value lang which actually directly maps to the physical memory. Dito, meron kang segment table, a segment number which is an offset in the segment table. Tapos nandun sa segment table yung information para makuha mo yung base na physical address and the limit address. Ang purpose niyan, para pwede mong paghiwa-hiwalayin yung ibang parts ng program. Ibig sabihin, kahit ibang parts ng memory nakakalat sila, okay lang. But still, they belong to the same process. Okay? And that actually prevents fragmentation. Okay? Ayan. So, the last one is paging. But to give you an example, okay, so, yung mga iba gumawa na na-try, nag-submit ng homework. So, this one here is, meron ditong part na, yan. This is for the x86. Okay? So, x86, supports both segmentation and paging. Okay? So, pag trinay nyo itong tutorial na to, you'll discover yung part 4 is more on setting up the global descriptor table and the interrupt descriptor table. So, this one here will demonstrate that. Okay? So, So this one here, so this is an example of the output of that portion of the tutorial. So na-set up niya yung interrupt descriptor table at meron siyang output dito for, kumbaga merong memory out, na-set up niya yung segmentation. Okay? So to view the code here, just to give you an idea, so this one here. Okay. So, this is the header file that describes the, sabi natin kailangan natin ng segment table, diba, that contains the base and the limit. Okay? So sa x86, this is called the global descriptor table. And this is an entry, isang, kung dun sa slide natin, okay? Sa slide natin, ito, base and limit, isang row na ganyan sa segment table. Okay? Ito yung isang row dun sa segment table. And it specifies sa structure na to. I hope you can understand structures, no? So this specifies the limit of that particular segment. And this specifies the base address of that particular segment. Okay? And this one here for protection, nandito yung sinasabi kaninang access bits, like is it read only, write only, execute. Okay? So that is, this is a row in that particular table. And this is for the global descriptor table, and this one is for the interrupts. Okay? This one is for the interrupts, and usually they have an array there that specifies the, so this one is an entry, and this one is the actual pointer. Okay? Di ba sabi natin, sabi dun sa slides, saan na ba yan? Okay, sabi dun sa slides, ito, kailangan mong iset yung location ng descriptor table, segment descriptor table. So this one is the query for that, okay? So, yan. And the code, ano yung code? Okay, so the code will tell us that this one points to the global descriptor table. Okay, so you can try this and look at the code. Okay? So, ito naman yung ldescript. Ito yung location kung saan ilalagay yung kernel sa memory. So this one is the memory location nung sa physical memory kung saan ilalagay yung kernel. So first 1 megabyte of memory. Okay? Doon yun makikita. Nasundan niyo ba? So yan. So this one is the implementation of the functions. So this one initializes the, for example, a typical program, x86 program, kailangan mo ng code segment, kailangan mo ng data segment, and this is for the, let's say, the kernel, and you have the for the code segment and data segment for user processes. Okay? So this is how it's done in an actual operating system if you want to implement segmentation. So these are the functions that basically sets that, okay? So this instruction, load GDT, is the one responsible for setting. Ito yung equivalent nitong yung pointer kanina, okay? So that's how it's done, okay? Operating systems do it that way. Okay? So malino ba yan? Okay. So this is segmentation. Okay. So the problem with segmentation is, una, it still suffers from internal fragmentation. Notice na variable yung sizes ng bawat segment. Ito, maliit lang siya. Ito, medyo malaki. Ito, pinakamalaki. You get the idea? So, a solution to limit the that problem is via paging. Okay. Yung idea ng paging is, divide mo yung ano i-divide mo yung memory into fixed size block. So you have physical address space, so a process can be non-contiguous, and process is allocated physical memory whenever the latter is available. And this one avoids external fragmentation kasi fixed size yung ano mo, yung chunk mo compared to segmentation. Okay? And avoids problem of varying size memory chunks. So what, how does it work? You divide the physical memory into fixed size blocks called frames, so yung physical memory. And the size of this is usually power of 2, okay? And in addition, you also divide the logical memory into blocks of same size called pages. So at this point in the study of operating system and study of memory, kailangan you always view memory two ways. You have the physical view of the memory and the logical or the virtual view of the memory. So sa paging, i-imagine ninyo, physical memory divided into fixed size chunks. Logical memory divided into fixed size chunks also. And they are of the same size, for example. Right? So pag frames, that refers to physical memory. Pag pages, that refers to logical memory. Right? So it says here that to run a program of size n pages, you need to find n free frames and load the program. So, di ba meron kang .exe? Ang gagawin ng loader mo, determine niya ano yung memory na kailangan niya, ilang pages, divided by, usually yung size ng pages ay 4 kilobytes. Kaya makakita niyo dun sa GDB, 0x1000, okay? Yun yung isang page, okay? Which is 4 kilobytes. Okay? So, that's what it does. Okay? So, yung process, yung operating system, kukunin niya yung estimate niya kung ilang pages ang kailangan ng process na yon, and then mag-allocate ng free frames based on the number of pages. And an important data structure here is called the page table. In the segment, in the segmentation part, the important data structure is called the segment table. Whereas in paging, the important data structure is called the page table. Okay? Which essentially translate the logical address to physical address. Okay? And kung mayroon kang swapping, you can actually split the disks, the disk allocation, disk blocks into the same size as the size of the pages. So, physical memory, let's say 4 kilobyte page size, frame size, logical memory, 4 kilobyte page size, disk, 4 kilobyte block size. Okay? So parang may 1:1 mapping sila. And although na-prevent ng paging yung external fragmentation, meron pa rin siyang internal fragmentation. So halimbawa, fixed size nga siya, 4 kilobytes. Tapos merong dumating na merong allocation ka na less than 4 kilobytes. So meron pa rin siyang internal fragmentation kasi yung buong 4 kilobytes, yun yung i-allocate niya. Okay? So, one of the interesting aspects of paging, kasi kailangan mo lang i-translate yung logical address into physical address, physical memory. So, how is address generated? Kanina, sa segmentation, yung logical address, dalawa yung composition niya. Yung segment number and the offset. Dito sa paging, ang component ng logical address will be the page number and the page offset. Okay? So you have the page number P, which is used as an index in the page table, okay, which contains the base address of each page in the physical memory. And the page offset, which is combined with the base address to define the physical memory address that is sent to the memory unit. So halos pareho lang siya nung segmentation, kaya lang ito fixed size yung blocks. Okay? Okay, you get the idea? And given this logical address, ito yung division niya. So page offset, and you have the page number. So for a given logical address space, this is the format, 2 to the m, and page size is 2 to the n. Okay? So given ka ng logical address, ito yung n mo. So the address space, total address space is 2 to the m. Okay? Yung buong yan, 32 bits. Okay? And the page size is 2 to the n. Okay? So yun yung ibig sabihin niya. So to illustrate this further, this is how it's done. So again, the CPU will generate two addresses. Since enabled yung paging, yung address will be composed of the page number, which will be an index to the page table, and then from that you'll get the offset, okay, the base address in the physical memory, frame number, frame position, and then you get the offset, and then you get the actual address. So parang ina-and lang siya dyan para makuha yung actual physical address. Okay? So again, the important thing to remember is you have fixed size blocks, fixed page size, frame size, and block size. Okay? So this is how it's done. Okay? So halimbawa, yung process, meron kang process na dumating. Sabihin ng process na or na-detect ng loader ng operating system, this process will require 4 pages. Okay? So this will be the logical memory of the process, and this will be the page table associated to the process. So ibig sabihin, yung page number 0 will be mapped to the frame number 1. Okay? And page number 1 will be mapped to page number frame number 4. Okay? So notice here na halos pareho siya nung sa ano, halos pareho siya nung sa segmentation. If you go back to segmentation, ito siya, halos pareho siya. Yung main difference niya is fixed size siya. Okay? You get the idea? So that is the main difference. And here is another example. Okay? So yung parameters natin, remember na yung parameters natin will be this one. This is the logical address, okay? divided into a page number and a page offset. So yung n natin, yun yung number of bits, okay? It specifies the page offset, and m is the total number of bits for the logical address, okay? The size, okay? So halimbawa, so ito yung logical memory, yung n natin equals 2 and yung m natin is 4, okay? So yung n, yun yung size ng page table, so 2 to the 2, that will be 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Size of the page table, and 4 will be the logical memory, so 2 to the 4, that will be 16 slots, okay? And what happens is, kung divided siya into 4, okay? So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then starting page 0, okay? This will be the start, page 0, okay? 0, and then it will go to the memory location 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So dito ngayon pupunta yung location ng, dito ngayon papasok sa physical memory, okay? 5 times 4, 20, so dito ngayon pupunta siya. Yung second, ano naman, second page, 4, this is the second page, so 4, so 1, 6, pupunta siya doon sa, dito siya pupunta. Okay? So you get the idea? So meron akong program, hello world, hello.exe, okay? Ito yung logical memory niya. Meron siyang corresponding na page table na nagsasabi kung saan actual memory siya nakalagay. Okay? And yung programmer, hindi niya alam na kalat-kalat pala sa memory yung ano, yung data niya. Ang alam niya dire-diretso yung kanyang memory. You get the idea, parang flat memory space. So that is the beauty of paging. Okay? Ang tingin ng process, flat memory model, pero actually yung operating system na yung bahala na maglagay niya ng ano. So medyo tricky actually yung pag-implement ng paging. Okay. So here is some calculations for fragmentation. Kasi meron pa ring internal fragmentation kasi fixed size yan eh. Paano halimbawa, ang laman lang ng data mo ay MNO, walang P. Pero nag-allocate ka ng for ganitong size. So sayang nung space na kinakain ni P na na-allocate mo dun sa page table na yon. Okay? So these are just some computations to describe how much internal fragmentation is incurred in a paging system. Okay? So okay. So frame allocation, okay? So sabi natin may dumating na process. Ito yung number of pages na kailangan ko. Yung operating system kailangan niyang maghanap ng slots dun sa main memory na pwede niyang paglagyan. Paano niya ginagawa 'yon? So usually merong tinatawag na free frame. Free frame list yung ano, yung operating system. This can be as ICSOS, this is implemented as a stack. Okay? Doon naman sa tutorial na ni James Molloy or something, ang implementation niya naman ay bitmap. Okay? Sa ICSOS, yung free frame niya, stack, nagpupush siya ng available frame, nagpapop siya. Okay? Para kumuha ng frame. Okay? So, ang ginagawa dito, so you have a new process and it will require 4 pages. Okay? So, ang gagawin ngayon, hahanap dun sa free frame list. Okay, so ito yung memory. So yung 14, free ba yung 14? The gray area would represent free frame sa physical memory. Okay? And then, pag nagawa, ang gagawin ng operating system, pwede, depende sa algorithm niya, pwedeng first come, first serve. So 4 pages, ang gagawin ng operating system, magse-set up siya ng page table for that particular process. And ang gagawin niya, sa pag-fill up niya ng page table, imamap niya. Page 0, ilalagay niya sa frame 14. Okay? So, page 0. Page 1, ilalagay niya sa page 13. Okay? Page 2, ilalagay niya sa next ay 18. Okay? Etc., etc. Eventually, you'll have the free frame list here. Remaining, 15 na lang yung natitira. Okay? You get the idea? And pag nag-terminate na yung process na to, or nag-exit na siya, ang gagawin ng operating system is ibabalik niya uli yung mga memory na na-allocate niya doon sa process na yon, doon sa free frame list. Para pag may dumating uli na process, ganun uli yung gagawin niya. You get the idea? So that is what we mean by frame allocation in paging system. Okay. Other questions? So sulit na lang yung tanong niyo dyan. So again, lahat 5 perfect kayo ngayon sa quiz. Okay? Yung mga umattend ngayong klase na to. Okay, so 5 out of 5. Okay? So put in 5. Okay, so how is the page table implemented in the hardware? Okay? So meron tayong page table base register which points to the page table, and you have the page table length register which indicates the size of the page table. Okay? In this scheme, every data instruction access requires 2 memory access. So, kanina, dun sa segmentation, meron tayong segment table. And pinakita ko sa inyo sa tutorial, the structures, okay? LGDT, which is used to load the address of the segment descriptor table, global segment descriptor table. Okay? Now here, we also have the same mechanism. Where do you place this page table? You place this also in the main memory. Okay? So you have to have these pointers to the page table. Okay? In this scheme, so dalawang memory access ang mangyayari basically. Parang dito kasi, pinapakita sa drawing na to na hiwalay yung page table. Pero pag in-implement actually yan sa operating system or sa hardware, nandito rin yan sa memory. Okay, you get the idea? Nandito rin yan somewhere. Dito pinakita lang siya na hiwalay, pero nandyan din yan somewhere sa memory. Kaya sinasabi dito na every memory access requires 2 access. Una, hahanapin niya dun sa page table, okay, na nandito, and then sa kanya kakaroon ng translation para mahanap yung actual address. Okay? So, that's the idea. And that is somewhat inefficient kasi dalawang memory access. Remember na pag memory access, medyo mabagal yan kumpara sa cache or kumpara sa register. Right? So they introduce what they call the a cache called TLB. Okay? Translation look aside buffer, which is basically used as a cache for the page table. Okay? So at this point in ano, at this point in 1125, you should now know the importance of caching in every aspect of computing. Okay? So dalawang sa pagtuturo ko ng 125, dalawang recurring theme ang laging essential sa systems. Una, yung virtualization. Pangalawa, yung caching. Laging ginagamit 'yan. Virtualization, virtual address, virtual machines, laging nandiyan 'yan, and caching. Kahit sa aspect, laging may caching, okay? From small scale to large scale, laging may caching. So I hope you will always remember the importance of these two concepts. Okay? So, meron tinatawag na TLB, and TLB is basically a fast, parang cache, okay? And you have simultaneous access, okay? Per clock tick, okay? And sabi dito that some TLBs have address space and identifiers, especially if you're using an inverted page table structure, which we're going to discuss later. Okay? So what happens here? So you have ASID, which we'll discuss later. And what is the size of the TLB? Since it is a cache, usually it has a smaller size. Okay? And since this is a cache, there will be, and it's smaller in size, there will be TLB miss or cache miss, okay, or cache hit. Okay? So, what it does is, kung wala dun sa TLB yung page number, saka lang siya pupunta dun sa memory kung saan nakalagay yung entry ng page number. Okay? Page number and offset. Remember that. Remember our logical address. Okay. The format of our logical address is page number and offset. Okay. So yun yon. Pupunta sa memory. Okay. So the idea of associative memory is fast search. Okay. So in one clock tick, malalaman niyo na agad kung nandun yung page na yon o wala. Okay. So address translation, you have a page number and then the offset. If P is in an associative register, they get the frame number out. Otherwise, get the frame number from page table in the memory. So normally, the programmer doesn't care about this anymore. The TLB is implemented in the hardware. Basta ang mahalaga lang, iload mo yung GDT, iload mo yung page table structure mo, and then bahala na yung hardware dyan. So, pag nag-search kayo ng, let's say, Intel Core i5, i7, i3, makakita nyo dyan yung TLB. May option dyan na TLB. Okay? Specification, kung gaano kalaki yung TLB. Okay? So, basically, what you did here is, naglagay ka lang ng TLB. Okay? This is the original paging architecture, pero since mabagal nga siya kasi ito ay nasa memory, you introduce a cache. And the main difference here is, sabay, in parallel, ito pala ay miss lang. So, check muna dito, and notice this arrow, sabay-sabay yan. Okay? Sabay-sabay. Pag nandyan, TLB hit, okay, you get the frame number, get the offset, you get the physical address. Pag miss naman, wala dyan, punta dito, and then, lagay dito, and probably place that back in the TLB, and you get the physical address. Okay? The idea? So these are just some computations for the improvement provided by using a TLB instead of just having a page table in the main memory. Right? So you have protection. Right? So protection, memory protection, if you have a TLB or the page table, meron lang nakalagay dyan na valid or invalid. So yung mga page fault na lang nakikita nyo, usually mangyayari yan dito pag nag-access ka ng invalid na page entry dito. Okay? So yun yung isang protection. Okay? Okay, what are the advantages of paging? Code sharing. Okay? So pinakita ko sa inyo sa GDB nung nag infoproc mapping tayo. Meron doon mga live C na nakikita doon sa memory ng isang program, sa process. Okay? Those are part of the C runtime, and they are actually shared. Okay? Ang advantage nun, you minimize memory. So, ito yung example. Meron kang editor, text editor. Okay? Tapos, tatlong user, time sharing system to, tatlong user gumagamit ng Vim, for example. Nag-login sila sa isang server, walang GUI doon, so Vim yung gamit nila. So, yung Vim, meron siyang tatlong components, tatlong pages na ginagamit. Editor 1, Editor 2, Editor 3. Meron tatlong user na gumagamit ng Vim. Instead of having several Editor 1, several instances of the pages for Vim, ang pwedeng gawin ngayon is, dun sa page table ng process na yon, pansin nyo, na nandun, i-reuse nila yung 346, which is used by Vim. You get the idea? So, mapapansin nyo dito, pag, halimbawa, may Firefox kayo, nag-open kayo ng Firefox pang bagong instance, mapapansin nyo na yung pag-load ng bagong Firefox instance ay faster na. Diba? Kasi na-allocate na yung pages, na-reuse na yung pages na ginagamit ng Firefox. Okay? Diba? So, that's what I mean by that. Okay? So, we'll stop here and dito sa sa tutorial, meron din ditong about paging, which is 06. So, just to show this, you can all, of course, try this at home. Okay? And so, this one here is an example of paging. Okay? So, yung access violation, ito yung in protection mechanism. Okay? You try to access memory area, in this case, 0xA00, which is outside of the page table na na-allocate dun sa process na to. Okay, you get the idea? So, I will leave, yun sa mga gusto mag-explore, hayaan ko na lang kayong explore itong part na to. And the source code, of course, is there. So, you can examine the source code and understand, yun pala yung ginagawa ng okay? So, that basically ends our discussion on memory. May pinarong ba kayo? So, sagot nyo lang yung tanong nyo and then pass your paper. Okay, I'll be